Hi everyone, today we are going to talk about two topics. The first one is how to deal with missing values. And the second one is how to do a first step of exploration of your data set. So first of all, let's look at dealing with missing values. In real data projects, it's very likely that you will have missing values in your data. So for example, I'm going to use the air quality data set. If I run this line, I will be able to use this data. I can also run question mark on the data set to check all the detailed variables in the data on the right side. So you can see this is a data frame with 153 observations and 6 variables. And we also have the details of each variable. But the point here is that you can actually run dimension on the data set to see how many observations you have and how many variables you have. And also you can run a summary function on the data set, on the whole data set. So you will have a printout of all the summaries of each variable. And also this summary will help you see which variable is recorded as a numerical variable and which variable is a categorical variable. So for this data, you are seeing all variables are numerical variables and there are missing values. For missing values, I have 2 points here. The first one is to get rid of the records where you are seeing missing values. So the second point is that if you do have missing values and the data you have is a very small data set, so you may not be able to get rid of the records just because you have a few missing cells. So you may do data imputation if that's the situation. But we will not talk about how to do data imputation here, but I'm going to talk about how to get rid of records, including missing data. So let's think about how to check if there is missing values in our data. The first way we have talked about is just to run a summary function. And the second way is to run is .na on the data set and you add a sum function in front of it. So if the sum function is giving you a number that is not zero, that means you have 44 missing values in the data. And to get rid of them, you can use na.omit of the data set. So this is a quick and easy way to get rid of all the missing values in the data set. And you can assign, rename the data set as air quality no NA. So I often define a data set without missing values as underline no NA. I will never replace the old data set with changes. So I just rename it. And then if I ever want to go back to the original data set, I still have that data there. So if you run this line and you check the dimension of this data set, you're going to see this is a smaller data set with the same number of same number of variables, but a smaller number of observations. And if you run the sum is .na, you should get a number zero. See, there is no missing values here. And the second thing I want to talk about is a new function called ggpairs within ggally, a package called ggally. So if you have never used that package before, you should type install.packages and then use ggally. So in that way, you run that line, and after it, you load the package before you use it. So line, and then you can use the ggpairs within the package. So for here, I'm going to use, maybe we can use air quality here and see air quality no NA. So we know all the variables we have are numerical variables, but we do have date and we do have month variable there. So, but let's see, let's take a quick look and see what the data or what the graph looks like. So this ggpairs is showing is a great visualization tool showing you the pairs of the variables in the data. So if I zoom it, and those curves here are the density curves for each variable. So for this first one is ozone, solar, wind, temperature, months, and day. And the scatter plots are actually the scatter plots of two variables. So for this plot here, it is the scatter plot of ozone and solar. And if you look at this scatter plot here, it is the month and the day scatter plot, although it is not important at all, but they are showing all the pairwise scatter plots of all the numerical variables. So here, let me show you another data set, which is called Iris. I will not tell you more details about the data set, but you can definitely run question mark on the data set to see the details. But what I want to show you here is that using ggpairs on a data set with both numerical variables and categorical variables, you are going to see the results to be very amazing. Let's wait. And we can see it here. So you can see in this data set, we have four numerical variables. We have species, which is a categorical variable with three categories. And we have density curves for each categorical variable. And we also have box plots. We have a bar plot for the species, which tells us how many observations we have for each category. And we do have scatter plots and correlation coefficients for the paired numerical variables. And we also have box plot of the categorical variables according to categories in the categorical variable. So those are very super helpful results, because for here you are seeing a very high correlation, a high correlation and a high correlation. And also we can see the histogram of the numerical variables according to species category. And also for the box plot, you are seeing, for example, the petal width here, all the boxes, they are about kind of separate from each other, which means there may be a significant difference of the petal width according to different species.